Hi, this is Joël Meyer. I propose to create a finger puppet in the shape of a bee. Bees play a very important role in nature because when they collect nectar, they carry pollen from one flower to the next and that enables plants to reproduce. Use a yellow foam sheet to make the body of the finger puppet. Take the pattern in the supporting document and trace it twice on the foam sheet. Cut out both sides of the bee's body. You can see that there is a small tab on the top. The tab will be used to attach the body of the bee to the head. Put glue on the slanted sides of one of the foam layers as well as on the top. You have to use a glue that is specifically for foam, otherwise it will not stick. Then, overlay the two layers of foam to glue them together. Wrap the body of the bee in waxed paper or aluminum foil and then place two or three books on top to help bond the two layers of foam together. The glue takes at least an hour to dry. While the glue dries, take a styrofoam ball of about 1.5 inch in diameter to make the head of the finger puppet. To avoid getting your fingers dirty, put a toothpick into the styrofoam ball and hold the toothpick while painting the ball in yellow. If necessary, add a second coat of paint. Let the styrofoam ball dry completely. When the body of the bee is ready, take a ruler and draw horizontal lines on the body with an indelible black marker. Color every second band black to represent the stripped body of the bee. Do the same thing on the other side of the body. When the bee's head is dry, make a slit on one side with a scissor blade or a knife. The slit is where you will insert the tab on the body of the bee. Put hot glue in the slit and then glue the body to the head. Glue two googly eyes on the head. Take a black pipe cleaner and cut two pieces of about 2 inches long and stick them on top of the head. They form the antennas of the bee. Take an indelible black marker and draw the mouth of the bee. And to finish the bee's face, make a black dot to represent the bee's nose. Use the back of a paintbrush and black paint. Let dry completely. Take iridescent cellophane to represent the wings. Cut a strip of cellophane and fold it in four. Cut out the wings. This gives you four wings that are more or less the same. Turn the bee over and glue the wings on the bee's back. Instead of using cellophane, you can represent the wings with white pipe cleaners. Take two pipe cleaners and fold them in half. Cut them. Then, fold them into a rounded shape to represent the bee's wings. Glue them to the back of the bee's body with hot glue. Glue two wings on each side of the body. To print the document with the illustrated instructions and the pattern, click on the link below the video and visit the Anemaplates website to find hundreds of other fun projects.